We're at Gertrude's at the Baltimore Museum of Art, and tonight we're going to be honoring the VIP list, which is very important professionals 40 years old or younger. Tonight we recognize 43 VIPs selected for the significant contributions they are making to their professions and to improving their communities.
Our honorees work tirelessly, excelling in their careers, but they also use their influence and knowledge to help create opportunities for others. They value their professional accomplishments, but commit time and resources to civic involvement and making a significant positive impact on Maryland.
You don't do what you do to be recognized, but it's always good to get a pat on the back every now and then.
Well, it certainly puts a lot of pressure on the next 40 years. So I expect to be able to surpass what I've done in the first 40, and it is very motivating to keep going. It's nice to be recognized.
We feel people of this caliber need to be recognized, and we want them to know about us as we want to know about them.
It does inspire you, first of all, and to definitely just remain as actively involved, if not more, in the community and at my job, and just to kind of give back as much as I can.
We use an outside panel of judges. Many of them are made up of VIP winners from past years, and they're looking for three criteria. They're looking for professional achievement by 40, they're looking for community service, and a commitment to inspiring change.
I was looking for the people that I felt did the most for the community, led by example that way. And if you're taking care of the community in turn takes care of the business. So it's a continuous cycle.
It seems like a lot of the people out here, the recipients, are doing a lot of good things in the community, in Baltimore particularly. So it's nice to be part of that.
Night out in the town in the middle of the week. To be one of 40 in the whole state of Maryland is a huge accomplishment, I think. I'm very honored.
With the Daily Record and the VIP event and all these up-and-coming leaders, we thought, where else can we put our support, and to make sure that we have the right impact in our community? So we're very excited about being part of it.
Completely inspires me to do better and to move forward and to continue the work that I'm doing. And being around all these other great people who are also winners just inspires me more to learn what they're doing and to even make new relationships that we can collaborate together on different things.
I think looking at past award winners, you just see what they have accomplished, and so it inspires me to want to do more.
Winning honors like this is really always wonderful, and it keeps you going on the bad days and inspires you to strive and achieve.
It inspires me to continue to help mentor the next generation of leaders in our state.
It's certainly further encouragement to continue to do what we have been doing as far as local charities, the nonprofits who really help to support the economy around here. It's going to be fun to be able to do that more.
The award illustrates what effect and impact that young people can have on our collective culture and the community.
It also honors the people, the whole team that I work with, and all of my collaborators, so it's a really exciting experience.
Just seeing actually some old friends. One of my best friends from high school, who I haven't seen in probably 10 years, also got nominated, and she's from the Eastern Shore, so it's really fun to reconnect at something like this.
By learning about the great work that the other awardees are doing, and also it's just really encouraging to get the recognition for public interest work and to keep working to raise awareness of issues like homelessness.
It's fabulous. I love the Daily Record, and this award is such an honor, and being in the company of such fabulous individuals is great.